went on YouTube land. And here we are, then getting towards the end of the year, and soon I will be doing my top 10 films of 2019. But before that, here are my list of the top 10 most anticipated movies of 2020. 2020 is upon us, people. It's not far away at all. Scary, isn't it? Anyway, I do have some honourable mentions, 10 honourable mentions, because let's face it, over a year there's going to be more than 10 films you want to see. Well, for me anyway. But the honourable mentions, some of these may surprise you, that they didn't make to my top 10 most wanted to see. Never mind. So first of all, we've got Top Gun Maverick, the sequel to Top Gun. I've never seen Top Gun. Don't judge me, people. I will watch it before the new one. It looked quite good, so I'll give it a go. We got Free Guy with Ryan Reynolds. That's the one. Deadpool. There's a comic book movie sort of action, comic, computer game, comedy action thing. Looked quite good. Antlers, a horror movie. Very dark horror movie by the looks of it. Character piece. Looks really good. I got the new Harley Quinn film. It might be a bit of fun. Onward, a Disney movie with Chris Pratt and the one who plays Spider-Man, whose name has completely left my mind right this moment. But it's a Disney movie. It looks quite fun. You got Bad Boys 3, which with Will Smith and Martin Lawrence. I love those movies, so I'll be looking forward to seeing that one. Black Widow, another one probably people are thinking, why is that not on the list? It just isn't. James Bond, No Time to Die. That's right, that's on the list as well. I do like the James Bond movies. Don't love them, but I do like them. But Casino Royale is fantastic. So, and Skyfall was very good as well. So I'm looking forward to seeing this one. We won't talk of Quantum of Solace. I thought that was a big load of whoop. And we've also, what was the other one? Spectre. That was okay. It was okay. Next on the list, 1917, there's a war movie, looks really good. And you got the guilty pleasure, Sonic the Hedgehog, mainly because of Jim Carrey. I do love Jim Carrey, I've always been a fan of his since I was a young lad. So he was my favourite actor for a very long time, so I have to put that in there as well. The film might be okay. We shall see. Right then, the top 10 most anticipated movies of 2020. And we're going to start off then with Wonder Woman 2, set in the 80s. It looks like an action-packed blockbuster. And the first Wonder Woman is one of the best comic book movies we've had in a long time. I really do think that because it's a good story. It's really funny. It goes at a great pace. And it's the right amount of woman power without it being rammed down your throat. Moving on to The Witches remake with Anne Hathaway. I love the original I love the original Witches. I grew up watching that when I was a young lad. I absolutely loved it. And so it's nice that they're doing a remake. I wonder what they're going to do with it. I hope they involve the mice. I really do, because it is a great story. Great story by Roald Dahl. I remember reading the book as well. I love this the original, and I hope they get a UK release on Blu-ray. Really do. Conjuring 3. I really want to see this. I love the Conjuring movies. 1 and 2 are both good. And a lot of the Conjuring spin-off movies have been pretty good as well. Annabelle Creation, for example, is one of the best in the franchise. The Conjuring franchise. Candyman remake. I want to see this. I love the original Candyman with Tony Todd. Absolutely love it. It's one of my favourite horror movies. And it doesn't get the attention that it deserves. The first hour in particular is it's like watching a really superbly crafted horror movie. The last sort of half an hour sort of goes down the generic road and it has sort of a somewhat satisfactory ending. But overall, I love it. Just the idea, the story, the direction, the music. The music in Candyman is phenomenal. It really is. Moving on, Bill and Ted 3, Face the Music. I love the Bill and Ted films, like I said. There are a lot of sequels and remakes and prequels and all the rest of it coming out. But I really am looking forward to Bill and Ted 3 with the original cast all returning. It should be a lot of fun. I hope they pull this one out of the bag. Godzilla vs. Kong. It's going to be out later than we planned in March. But it's going to be out, I think it's in like November time, September, November. I can't remember. It's between that sort of time. There's no footage, but oh my god, I am so looking forward to it. It's going to be awesome. Halloween Kills, the sequel to Halloween from 2000 and 18. And I loved 2018 Halloween. I thought it was a fantastic return to form. You have the original Halloween, that was fantastic. You have, I liked Halloween 4. I liked 2 and 3. You know, I liked 2, 3 and 4. And 5 is okay, and 6 gets a little wobbly. And then you get towards, like, H2O was a good comeback, where it was 20th anniversary. And then you had the follow-up. Yeah, moving on. And then we had this one, and it went back to the original sort of feel of the very first one, at least. All the sequels did their own thing, and they created that their own sort of style, if you will, or feel, whatever you will. But this remake felt more closer to the original movie than any of the other sequels, in my opinion. I don't think it's as good as some of the previous films, but it was certainly better than a couple of the most recent ones. Certainly better than the remakes that we got. Moving on then. So yes, that's coming out around Halloween, obviously, and I'll be there opening morning. The very first show, and I'll be going to that, regardless of what time it's on. Can't wait for that. Halloween Kills. Then we're getting close now. Top three, Quiet Place 2. I love A Quiet Place. We can relax and chill. No, the film with Emily Blunt. And I'll tell you why. Because it made everybody in the cinema fucking shut up for 2 hours. Oh, it was lovely. I can't wait to see the continuation of this story. I love the original one. It was a fantastic horror movie with a great concept. It's a bit like Tremors. Instead of not making a noise, you'd have to stay still. But I still love A Quiet Place. I look forward to part two. Second most anticipated movie is Mulan. That's right, the live-action version. And you know what? I know it might not have the songs. It might not have Mushu. But the trailers have sold me. It looks really good. It looks like it's going to be quite an emotional epic, and I can't wait to see all the action and all the story unfold as it goes along. The acting is very good, and Donnie Yen's in there, for goodness sake. So I'm very much looking forward to Mulan. Really looking forward to it. And now, the number one movie I'm most looking forward to next year is Ghostbusters 3, or Ghostbusters Afterlife. And this is a continuation of the story based on the characters after the original main characters, you know, Bill Murray and Harold Ramis, Dan Aykroyd and Ernie Hudson. I do believe that this is a continuation, and it's focusing on one of the Venkman's granddaughters. And is it Venkman? No, that's Peter Venkman, that's Bill Murray. Oh, you know who I mean. Harold Ramis' character, Egon. It's about his family, and they go out to this barn in the middle of the countryside, where he kept all his bits and bobs, so we say, and all hell breaks loose. And it's got some great new cast members there. Paul Rudd is in it, and Sigourney Weaver's going to be in it, and Bill Murray, and all the rest of them, they're all returning. So, and you've got the kid out of Stranger Things, and it, and, oh, I can see him, Finn Wolfhard. He's in it as well. So I'm really looking forward to seeing Ghostbusters. The trailer really did sell it for me. I thought it looked very good indeed. So there we go. That is it. That is my top 10 anticipated movies plus 10 sort of sideliners I want to go and see anyway. So tell me, what are you looking forward to seeing in 2020? We're going to the 20s, people. So tell me down below in the comments what you want to see. Is there anything off my list you want to see? And is there anything that's not on my list you want to see? Like I said, comment down below, and I look forward to seeing what you're looking forward to. I really am. Looking forward to it. So anyway, guys, take care for now. I'm about to go and see Star Wars. Oh yes, I'm gonna go see Star Wars, and I don't give a fuck about any of the bad reviews. No, because I go on my own, so fuck them. But everybody's entitled, like I say all the time. But I'm just looking forward to it. I really can't wait. But I'm looking forward to this pretty much all year. So it's Star Wars. Who doesn't want to go and see that? People who have a life. I'm joking. Anyway, everybody, take care from now, and Christmas is only a few days away, so hope you have a lovely Christmas. There will be a Christmas Day message at 3 o'clock, maybe. We shall see. Take care, everybody. See you again soon. Bye for now.